I was planning on doing this in a different way. But a couple of days ago, I saw that Alex made an effort to make it easier to add more remote backends to the integration. So I pivoted and decided to contribute my own. I sent it yesterday, so it's still in the development branch. So today, finally, I'm going to show you Daisy's local AI control for your smart home, using Ollama and Home Assistant. And if you're ready, let's go! To get this working, we are going to need a working Ollama installation. If you don't know how to get that, you can watch this video. And the Home LLM model. This is a new version of the AI model specially trained to control Home Assistant. It is a very simple model that can be used to control lights, switches, and other smart devices on your home. It has been specially trained to work with this integration. To install it, you can go to Tags. And here, just copy the name of the tag that you want to use. And then go to Ollama Web UI, click on the gear, click on Models, and here just paste the name and click on the green button. If you want to know more about the Home LLM model, check out this video. Once it's finished, just go back to my website. And now I'm going to show you how to activate the WSL server mode. For this, we are going to use WSL port. It's a PowerShell script that allows you to easily redirect and open ports in the Windows firewall for the WSL services. It also prevents Windows from shutting down WSL, so you don't have to keep a terminal open. Now, to get it, just click here. I try not to bore you with the details, but if you want to know more about how the script works, check out the comments in the code. Then click on the three dots here and click on download. Then open the file explorer and we need to move the script to this location. For this, just copy it and now go to your C drive. Here we need to create a folder. We are going to call it WSL ports. And inside we are going to paste the script. And now to test it, we need to open a PowerShell window as an administrator. For this, click Start, look for PowerShell, right-click on it, and select Run as Administrator. Click on Yes, and here you can just copy the location from my web, and paste it on the terminal. And then hit Enter. And that's it. Now, if you open a new tab, and you go to your PC's IP address, and then enter the port 3000. And then just hit enter. And that's it. And just to show that it also works from a different device, I'm going to open a new tab from my phone. And that's it. Now go back to my website. And now we are going to automate the execution of the script at Logon. For this, just copy this code. And we're going to paste it on the PowerShell terminal. And then hit enter. This might happen to you if you don't have your Windows installation in English. If this is your case, you just need to translate this word to your language. In my case, administradores. And then just paste it. And that's it. Now, every time that you log on, the script will set everything up automatically. And thus, we need to install the Llama conversation integration. If you're seeing this message, it means that the Ollama API support is still in development. So we need to use the develop branch. For this, just click here. Click on Open Link. Here, if you haven't installed it yet, you can click on Download. If not, go to the three dots here and click on Redownload. Then click on the dropdown and select Develop. And then click Download. After finish, go to Developer Tools and click on Restart. After finish, go to Settings, click on Devices and Services, and here click on Add an Integration. Here, look for Llama Conversation, and we are going to select Ollama API. Then click Submit. Here, enter the IP address of your PC. Then enter the port for Ollama. And on model name, we are going to paste the name of the model that we got from the Ollama library. Here, you can also use any model file from the Ollama web UI, as long as it is based in the Home 3B model. and you can find more of them using the Ollama Hub community. Just select the one that you want to try, click on Get, click on Import to Web UI, and here just edit the base model. And then just click on Save. Now you can use this model file in Home Assistant. And then just click Submit. And finish. Now go to Settings, and here click on Voice Assistants, click on your assistant, and in Conversation Agent we are going to select the one that we just created. And then just click Update. Now go back to Overview, and if you open Assist, and that's it. With this, you got the easiest way to get a local AI to control Home Assistant. And if you want to go back to the stable release, just go back to my website. Here, click on this button, click on Open Link, and here just click on the three dots and click on Redownload. And this time select the last version available, and then just click Download. And remember that you can update, just copying and pasting these commands to the Ubuntu terminal. So always remember to update from time to time. If you like my work, please consider joining the channel or becoming a patron, like Flip. And if you can't, don't worry. Just remember to share this video and give it a like. And of course, don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. I'll see you on the next video. Bye!